calling this meeting to order. This is, it's 10 a.m. This is the Barnstable County Board of Regional Commissioners, and we are located in the Commissioners Meeting Conference Room at, in the Superior Courthouse at 3195 Main Street, Barnstable Village. If everyone will join me with the Pledge of Allegiance, I'd appreciate it. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I'd like to have a moment of silence for all those serving, who were killed serving our country in the military, and those currently past and present who also serve in the armed forces of the United States. Thank you. Okay. Is there any public comment?
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you.
Please state your name.
My name is Janice O'Connell, member of the public and coincidentally employee of the county.
Okay.
Happy holidays.
You too.
And thank you for allowing me the opportunity to make a public comment. Today, I'd like to make a comment with regards to an item that you have on your agenda. I'll refer to it as 6B, Discussion on Possible Placement of Speed Limit Signage at Locations on the County Campus. If you'll allow me to just read a brief statement. As a member of the public and employee of the county who regularly navigates throughout the county campus, I can tell you that attempting to control the speed at which motor vehicles operate on the campus will be challenging. Will the cost and effort be worth it? Yes, I believe it will. But you need to consider the costs associated with repeated sign replacement after they are stolen and scrapped, and enforcement issues. I've witnessed some very bizarre and dangerous situations involving pedestrians and motor vehicles on the county campus. I don't park near the entrance door, but I do navigate from building to building. I believe you probably know that several years ago, an employee was struck by a vehicle on campus. First, let me say that if you're going to move in the direction of limiting speed on the county campus, please do it right. Consider all methods of traffic calming, as it is commonly referred to. Although some of these methods may carry a higher cost, please do what is in the best interest of the public, state, and county employees within reason. It is a fact that the use of traffic calming devices results in fewer traffic accidents. The emphasis here at the county should reflect a concern and a measured response related to the safety and convenience for pedestrians, cyclists, and motorists. Traffic calming can slow down and reduce traffic, which encourages walkers and cyclists to share the space. There are also devices available that will not exacerbate the burden on our facilities department. Traffic calming devices can be simple, inexpensive, self-enforcing, and easily modified or removed to accommodate maintenance vehicles. Really, though, I think what you need is an overhaul plan to include things like sidewalks, but big plans cost money, take time, and must be part of a big-picture approach. In the meantime, there are some things that you can do to temporarily address the problem. For example, consider installing speed bumps, removable, or speed humps, paved. These types of devices are physically self-enforcing drivers to slow down to avoid an uncomfortable ride or possible damage to their cars. These devices can be designed to achieve a desired speed of about 15 miles an hour, which drivers are physically compelled to meet. Speed bumps only cost around $2,000 and require little maintenance. There are many more examples of traffic calming devices that you may consider for the county campus. I also want to bring your attention to another matter of concern regarding traffic on the county campus, and that is the need, at the very least, for a stop sign here at the campus at the intersection of Railroad Avenue and the main entrance road. This particular area is somewhat like a Bermuda Triangle. Register of Deeds, Superior Court, Main Access Parking, and other buildings. Very congested and dangerous with limited visibility. I've asked about getting a stop sign erected several times. but these types of signs get stolen. A stop sign may not be preferred over a speed bump or hump, but note that drivers will often ignore a stop sign in a new location, and this may be a situation that will require continual enforcement, something that we really don't have the personnel or power to do. A little bit like throwing a deck chair off the Titanic. So again, whatever you choose to do, please do it right. Yes, safety comes at a cost. I am of the opinion that you need to do something. The situation and interaction with traffic and pedestrians is scary on the campus, and you only know that if you're out there navigating it. You have an opportunity to demonstrate to all that safety is a priority. If there is anything that I can do to assist you in your efforts, please don't hesitate to ask. For example, Safety Committee. I am sincere in my comments related to this issue, an issue that you felt was important enough to place on your agenda.
Thank you very much. Is there any other public comment? Okay. With that, I also need to state, is there any member of the public or anyone other than county staff taping this meeting? Okay. With that, we'll go to the next agenda item, which is approval of minutes. 5A, executive session minutes of December 5th, 2018. May I have a motion to...
I move to approve the minutes of December 5th, 2018.
And I second.
I thought Owen was raising his hand. He wasn't.
This is the executive session minutes of December 5th. I did review it and everything looked fine. So we'll vote.
Okay, I move to approve.
Okay, and I second it. So, BDI?
We're voting. Flynn, aye.
Okay. And then 5B, regular meeting minutes of December 12th, 2018. May I have a motion to approve those?
I move to approve the meeting minutes of December 12th, 2018.
And I second. And I also reviewed those and made some minor corrections with Owen. And so we'll vote to approve them.
I moved to approve already.
Yeah. All right, so
BDI? Flynn, aye.
Okay. And the next item, six, general business 6A, discussion on the Cape Cod Commission's preparation of the Comprehensive Economic Development Strategy, SEDS, for Cape Cod. We have some people in the commission. And please state your name so the public knows who you are. And these are the handouts you gave us?
Yes. Good morning. My name is Leslie Richardson, and I'm the Chief Economic Development Officer for the Commission.
And I'm Heather Harper. I'm Chief of Staff.
Welcome.
Thank you. Yes, I provided two handouts, one which is a time schedule of the five-year update of the Comprehensive Economic Development Strategy, and the other is sort of a description of what that strategy is about, what needs to be included, and what the process is for developing the plan as well as approving the plan. So just quickly, we update this plan, which is the Comprehensive Economic Development Strategy for Barnstable County, every 5 years. And we did a major update in 2009. We updated it again, but sort of retained some of the basic framework in 2014. And so now in 2018 and 19, we're going to do a fairly significant major update again, involving as many stakeholders as possible, from nonprofit sectors that support economic development to the private sector as well as the public sector. This will begin with a kickoff event in the end of January, January 31st, where we'll be bringing hopefully around 60 to 100 stakeholders together to identify the top 3 to 5 issues that we should be addressing over the next 5 years to make sure that our economy continues to grow and is resilient in the face of inevitable changes that will be occurring in our region and to our economy. So out of that, we'll be getting those priorities, and from those priorities, we will be convening groups, stakeholder groups again, leadership groups of different stakeholders around specific issue areas that pertain to economic development, those being infrastructure, workforce and sector development, and then business development and business climate, to take those priorities and create an actual action, 5-year action plan around those with specific priority projects or initiatives that they want us to accomplish in the next 5 years. That will all be brought, pulled together into a draft document by the end of March, the middle of April, and then released for public comment for 60 days. Then those comments will be incorporated and a final document will be prepared for approval by the Barnstable County EDC, which is the strategy committee for this process. And then it will be brought to the Cape Cod Commission, which approves it on behalf of the county as the regional planning agency. From there, it's delivered to the U.S. Economic Development Administration, which is the entity, the federal entity that provides the framework for this document. And the reason that we do this document and have it certified by the U.S. Economic Development Administration is so that we can retain our current designation as an economic development district and receive the funding that goes with that designation from the feds that we get annually, about $70,000 annually. As well as a region, we are eligible, and as the towns within the region, they are eligible to apply for EDA funding as well. And in the last year, we've actually been a partner with the UMass Dartmouth and Southern, it's SERPET, I can't remember all of the names to it, but the Regional Planning Agency for the Southern Coast of Massachusetts, and received a EDA grant to help develop the Marine Science Technology Cluster. And one of the towns has a pending approval for a large over $2 million grant from EDA for wastewater treatment, but it hasn't been officially announced, so we can't give you any more details than that. But the fact that we've been doing this SEDS now for 10 years, and we got the Economic Development District designation, is now starting to pay off with real funds coming from.
Seems like.
And the county actually has played a significant role in this by dedicating license plate funds to the implementation of the SEDS. I don't think the EDA would have given us the district designation without that commitment. So it's really been a very successful effort thus far, and I'm happy to answer questions. And Heather can, you know, put that in the larger perspective of what the commission does.
Well, just a couple comments. Leslie does a really great job sustaining a very positive relationship with the EDA, making sure that we're on top of what the programming and the framework is for the approach to the Comprehensive Economic Development Strategy. And there's a little bit of a new approach this year where the EDA, not surprisingly, has asked every region to focus on resiliency, and not just the physical resiliency of the region in terms of coastal change, but the business resiliency and the ability of the community to respond to any type of change in the economy. It could be a recession, it could be a shift in a particular industry or sector, but really focusing on the systems that we have in place to sustain the economy through times of change. So that will be an approach that we'll be taking a close look at in the update of the strategy. And anything you know, that Leslie is reporting on, these are programs that are supported by our Chief Economic Development Officer, but are really programs of the overall agency of the Cape Cod Commission. And so there are multiple staff that support any of the programs that we work on, and there are several of them underway now.
Definitely, yes. And in addition to the commission, there are also other agencies around the Cape that have been sort of taken the lead on regional priority projects that were identified in the SEDS. So it's not just a commission effort, it's a regional effort.
And forgive me if you already mentioned it. How does the SEDS tie in with the regional policy plan?
We think of the regional policy plan as kind of the umbrella, and then each of the more specific issue area plans as sub-plans. So it specifically ties back by adopting the growth policy into the SEDS itself, which is part of the regional policy plan. And then it also, the goals in the SEDS reflect those of the regional policy plan. So they may not, the wording may not be exactly the same because we don't include every single individual goal from the regional policy plan, but we have, we've got five draft goals right now that we'll be bringing to the full BCEDC today, actually, to review and adopt for the SEDS that reflect those that are in the RPP.
If you think about the RPP as really an overarching plan for the region with multiple issue areas, the Comprehensive Economic Development Strategy is the tactical plan to support the issues of the regional policy plan. So it's the branch that allows us to pursue those goals and to establish a framework for collaboration with other private and public agencies across the Cape.
With the goal really being jobs, investment, wealth creation.
So both the regional policy plan and the SEDS are undergoing their 5-year update at this point. And yes. When does the RPP end? And I know you said the SEDS starts in January and it ends in what, June?
June 30th that we submit it to you.
So, so is the RPP ending its review this month?
January.
Yes, so it was adopted by the full commission at their meeting last week and forwarded to the assembly for their approval.
And they'll be looking at it in January?
Yes.
And does the SEDS get the same, is the process similar or is it a little different?
It's a little bit different because it's not...
Does it go to the assembly too or no?
No, because it's not an ordinance. So the RPP has that extra level of legal standing,
yeah.
I guess.
Yeah.
Whereas this is more of a operational, like tactical, as Heather said, document.
Right.
That's supposed to guide staff and then our partners.
Interesting. Any
questions?
Yeah.
What are the revenues that SEDS receives now, say on an annual basis?
So, the SEDS program. So every year we have a sort of an annual work plan for the commission itself, portion of that program. And that is funded in part by the grant from the EDA, which is $70,000, in part by Cape Cod Commission funds, and then in part by license plate funds, Cape and Islands license plate funds. And that amount varies per year. That's something that's negotiated between the commission and the county commissioners.
So just out of curiosity, what are the license plate funds average now about on an annual basis?
Yeah. The revenues, I think that the county gets around $350,000 to $400,000 in revenues each year.
But from the license plate?
Yeah, okay. And the commission doesn't get that whole portion. The Economic Development Council, the BCEDC Economic Development Council, will be today discussing a new structure for the grants program, which is the other element that is funded.
The procedures,
correct. So, and then there are a lot of the projects within the SEDS are also funded by other grants. One interesting example is that in the past we had a zero waste project, and we had it, which was focused on recycling, and we had a buy local project. Both of those are actually being run now by the Cooperative Extension Service.
Uh-huh.
And we were able to help get some funding, at least for the recycling position initially. And so, you know, these things are much broader than just the commission, and so the funding of them is multifaceted.
A lot of overflow. Thank you.
Interesting.
No problem.
Great, thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The next. That doesn't really require, that was just informational, so I don't think there's really any motion that needs to be made on that matter. Under general business item 6B, discussion on the possible placement of speed limit signage at locations within the county campus. We have our director of facilities here, and also Jack is available. This came up. We already had some public comment about it, but we do have a somewhat of a problem with people speeding through the county complex. On average, I almost get hit by a car probably once or twice a month, and I know that other people have expressed some concerns. For me, it's mainly in the rear area up by where the old jail and the sheriff's the old sheriff's residences, so people need to slow down. It's either people visiting here, or people, maybe it's people going to court, I don't necessarily know if it's, I don't think it's people that work here, but, you know, then again, you don't always know who they are, because you're busy trying not to get hit. And the other thing that was also mentioned to me was specifically was there's an issue coming off of Railroad Ave onto the county campus on that side of the Registry of Deeds. There's been some near collisions. Maybe there have been some collisions, so I was informed. So I just thought we should have a brief discussion about this, and then again, it's not something we need to vote on. We'll leave it up to Jack and the staff and the administration to tackle it how they see fit. But there is something going on, and it's overdue. I said signage, whether it's speed limit, stop sign, speed. Maybe I didn't even think maybe speed month. I don't know. Whatever's the most, you guys deal with it, but. What's your experience with all this? Has you heard anything in the past about any of this?
Well, yes. As the volume of traffic over the years has increased, so has the obvious problems associated with that. That Railroad Ave section, going to your stop sign point, some years ago there was a stop sign as you exit the complex and get onto Railroad Ave. Apparently, with very little positive result. So whether or not, we're with the speed bump, additional signage, and perhaps our friends at Cape Cod Commission or perhaps another entity can sort of take a look at, observe some patterns, and decide how best to proceed.
Yeah, Tony and I have had a number of conversations about this recently because the parking lot's a mess. To repave it, given the fact that we're going to have to do a whole new storm drain system out there, it's going to challenge seven figures. So we are looking at options right now, and those options would include putting out an energy savings contract, an ESCO contract, and actually having a company come in to rebuild the parking lot to spec. With solar canopies over it, so that the county wouldn't have to come up with $1 million. The company would front the money, and the solar panels would be owned by the company, but leased to the county would lease the land that the canopies rise on. Obviously, that's a process, and Donnie and I have just started having conversations with this, but we want to vet that before you. Probably towards the end of January, and actually bring some of these companies in to tell you what they think they can do. It does work. They've done it in other court complexes, and certainly have done it at some of the state colleges. So that might be a solution. That would include traffic studies and rearranging some traffic flow volumes so that some of the concerns that Janice aptly raised can be mitigated against a little bit. Some of the others just will never be mitigated. People don't pay attention. They're on their cell phones. They back up without looking. But we can certainly do our best to mitigate against some of the more obvious ones. So.
Yeah, as Janice also mentioned during her public comment, there was a former staff member that actually got hit by a car.
Right. Yeah, that was a situation.
Somebody backed in, it was a little different, but but like I said, my experience has been the speed, and it's been more towards. That maybe there's issues down here, but I've never had issues. Here you got sidewalks, up there you don't. But you have to. Sometimes they come up this way, or they come whipping around that way. But people get hit. It's I don't know what the liability. Stuff. Of course, it's on the driver, really. So,
yeah. But certainly
it needs to be on the radar. Yeah. We need to be working on something. So maybe whether you put together a committee or however you want to approach it. But specifically, the speed of vehicles needs to be looked at. The other larger it's, you know, the other things you mentioned in the larger context, sure, that's more longer term and, you know, probably more financially burdening on the, possibly on the county, but, you know, I think we can look at signage as an interim stopgap measure.
Well, I think what we'd like to do then is to bring one of these companies, there are about six or seven of them in Massachusetts that regularly bid on these RFPs. Elaine now has a draft RFP which she can update. So we'd like to probably bring in one of these companies to meet with the commissioners sometime in January to vet and talk, discuss in detail what these plans look like and why it might be a good idea for us to go out. The problem in the past has been, Donnie can tell you this, DCAM has shown very little interest in ESCO agreements, although towns are doing them all over and counties are doing them. DCAM has been a little bit reluctant, but I think now they're starting to see that there's a huge cost savings for the Commonwealth to do the energy savings upgrades. So that any plan we would do, we'd want to include the Orleans Court in our buildings here as well. That way Donnie could get new HVAC systems in Orleans, which desperately needed, based on the savings. Because the new systems are so much more efficient and the energy savings are dramatic. It's the same with these buildings here, maybe windows, certainly lights.
How many spaces are there now? I mean, how many can we really actually accommodate for parking? Do you have any idea?
Ballpark, I think we're somewhere
around
250. There was an older study that I could reference and get back to you with it.
Yeah. It's just down here or everywhere?
Nope, complex wide.
The whole complex.
250.
Yeah. And how many do we really need? How many spaces do we should we have to accommodate
more.
The people who come in here aside from the employees?
That should deal more. Last study, I want to say, was done in the mid 90s. And even then, we were taxed.
Yeah.
Because sometimes if the courts are open and we have functions up at the Harborview Conference Room, and sometimes we get pretty
tight.
So
I mean, there's a lot of space out there, but it's probably
I've seen
not,
it filled up. I've seen it filled up. Yeah.
Yeah, but I mean, it could possibly accommodate more if it were
planned differently,
redesigned in some fashion. I mean, I don't know.
Right. Well, as we develop the East Wing, and I'll talk about that a little bit later, because it's not on the agenda. But as we finish up at the East Wing, and that if we run two conference rooms simultaneously, there's going to be real pressure on parking up there, because the upper campus is getting a lot busier than it's ever been. You know, since the sheriff was up there anyway.
Yeah.
So, it's. It's something we do. You're 100% right. We have to look at the redesigning, especially in the upper campus, some of the parking.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I'm sure that there could be a greater maximization of what's spaces available if it were redesigned in some fashion. Yeah. I don't know.
So, go ahead.
No, I was just going to say the East Wing will have...
I should know. I've worked on a lot of parking lots in my time.
Yeah, the East Wing will have 75 seats in it. And I'm sure for some of the Cape Cod Commission hearings, there'll be more people there than that.
So that's going to put in more of a burden up there.
A lot of pressure on the upper campus.
So back to the signage thing, if you chose to do so, is that, you know, putting a couple of signs up, that's something that the county could do in-house?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. And then the other thing we could do, remember, I think we have four signal boards up at the Fire Academy that we use for disasters. Those signal boards can type messages like slow down. We could experiment with those and see if they make a difference. And we could bring them down. You see them on the side of the roads all the time. A lot of the towns use those to remind people to slow down and this construction ahead, so on and so forth. But
great.
And maybe some of the signage could be solarized. You know, you only need them during the day. I mean, I don't know.
Yeah,
something to save, you know, to get people to see them and not cost us any money.
Because I know this,
and they might only flash if a car happened to approach it. They wouldn't be on, you know, flashing all day long. I mean, there must be some kind of...
Some police departments get grants specific, you know, in some areas, they you see a lot more of them now. You'll go through areas and they have a speed limit and they're solar. I know that they've gotten grants. That those a lot of, originally they were grant funded, at least in Barnstable. And now you're seeing a lot, even the street down from where I live, there's a couple of them in either direction.
Yeah.
Well, I'll talk to Phil Burr about that. I know Phil just filed a grant application yesterday for things you don't think of, but... our customer base for the shelters now are people over 70, and we didn't have any special needs cots. So Phil filed an application yesterday for 60 special needs cots with Homeland Security. So we've got staff here that look out the outer edge of things like this, and we'll see if that makes a lot of sense.
So maybe we'll review this again in a few months.
Okay.
There's a lot of space here if it were utilized, perhaps. I mean, in terms of... Where are we facing this way? All the space between here and the top of the hill.
Yep.
Excellent. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you. Okay. I had something else here. Bear with me, please. I'm new at this. Under new business, we did have something come to our attention. Authorizing the carryover of 75 hours of vacation time for Wayne Jadke of the County Dredge. So, Jack, information on that.
Thanks for taking these up. I'm going to talk a little bit more about the dredge during my report, but Wayne and Steve Bradbury.
There's another one for Steve Bradbury, also with the County Dredge.
They're our number one and two. Dredge leaders, and both have been working weekends. Both have postponed vacations because this is peak of dredge season, and running two dredges is a lot more than we thought in terms of time. So they both will lose this vacation time if we don't take it up today, because this will be our last meeting this year. And given the extra effort they've been putting in, I thought it was fair enough to ask you to take it on the business unanticipated. These both came in yesterday.
Right. Just to clarify, this is under new business or other business not reasonably anticipated by the chair.
But it is fair to them because they've been certainly working robust hours for us to get these projects done. As you know, we have the January 15th deadline when the winter flounder regulations take hold and put an end to our dredge program in a lot of the towns.
Okay, so under 7A, I need a motion for this to authorize the carryover of 75 hours of vacation time for Wayne, I hope I'm pronouncing his name correctly, Jadke?
Jadke.
Of the County Dredge to be used by March 15th, 2019 as presented.
So move.
I second. We'll vote on it. Beatty, aye.
Flynn, aye.
Okay. And then the next one under 7B, to authorize the carryover of 30 and one-half hours of vacation time for Stephen Bradbury of the County Dredge to be used by March 15th, 2019 as presented.
So move.
I second. And then we'll vote on it. Beatty, aye.
Flynn, aye.
It passes. Okay, and Section 8, Commissioners' Actions. 8A, authorizing the execution of a cooperative agreement with the Town of Harwich to do and perform all dredge-related work for Round Cove for an amount not to exceed $46,800. Okay, and I second. Is any discussion?
I don't think so, no. I don't have any questions.
Okay. And I've looked over the materials as well. So we'll just vote on it. Beatty, aye.
Flynn, aye.
Okay. And item 8B, authorizing the execution of an amendment to an agreement for a grant from the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration to Barnstable County for the Resilient Cape Cod Project, extending the termination date through June 30, 2019.
I'll move it.
And I second.
Yeah, I have a discussion. Is there any cost related to extending this?
No. Oftentimes these grants, especially with HUI, get approved, and because of the federal cycle being a little bit different than our local cycle, the work on these projects don't get started right away. So it's not unusual to them to come in and extend it out. It's the same amount. It was a little over $500,000, I believe, and it's all designated projects, so.
Okay.
The chargeback, by the way, from the county to the grant is by hour, generally speaking, with all our employees, so it's already planned.
Okay, but,
okay.
Did we vote it?
We just, we did.
No, I don't think we did.
BDI?
Oh, no.
Passes. And then 8C, authorizing the execution of an amendment to an agreement through the Cape Cod Commission with the town of Barnstable entered into September 5th, 2012 to support planning, design, and transportation improvements related to the Bursar's Way study area, extending the duration until December 31, 2020.
So move.
Second. And any discussion?
Nope.
I will vote. BDI?
Flynn, aye.
And it passes. And the next matter is 8D, authorizing an extension of an amendment to an agreement through the Cape Cod Water Protection Collaborative with the town of Falmouth, entered into December 21, 2016, for the Alternative Septic System Demonstration Project, extending the duration until December 31, 2019.
So move.
Seconded. Any discussion?
No.
We'll vote on it. BDI?
Flynn, aye.
And it passes. And the next matter is authorizing, 8E, authorizing the execution of documents for the Cape Cod Village Project in the town of Orleans through the Barnstable County Home Consortium under the Home Investment Partnership Program.
This is the... I'll move it, but what kind of documents?
So she moved it, and I second it, and discussion.
What happened last week, you remember, that Beth came in to talk a little bit about, or I came in on behalf of Beth to talk about the investment of the home monies. We were one of six sublenders to a project in Orleans that was constructing affordable housing for autistic adults. Truro, Wellfleet, Orleans, Brewster, Chatham, the county, were all participants in this project. And of course, the private sector picked up the bulk of the cost. Mm-hmm. So last week you voted to approve that, and this is just authorize us then to enter into the contracts that supported that. So,
thank you. Owen, do we have any certificates for dissolving septic betterments today?
We do. I received some this morning.
We do?
Yes.
Okay, so. So I'm going to need a...
I'll move to execute the certificates for the betterments.
Oh, did you vote the last motion? Or did you just move it?
Well, BDI.
Flynn, aye.
Just to cover ourselves.
You can make a motion.
Okay, so...
for you to sign the more...
Alright, so the next one, AF, is authorizing the execution of certificates for dissolving septic betterments.
So move.
Seconded. BDI.
Flynn, aye.
Okay, so that covers us. Any commissioners' reports?
Not for me.
I don't really have anything. County administrator and staff reports?
I just want to confirm, on January the 11th, we'll be journeying over to Falmouth. I've replied in the affirmative for both of you and Commissioner-elect Bergstrom to attend the first in years County Commissioner's symposium. You'll be with the reps from Bristol, Plymouth, Dukes, Nantucket, and Norfolk, and possibly Franklin. We haven't heard back yet from Franklin. And we'll be meeting at La Cucina,
a
place that
yeah.
you recommended to me. So that was That was confirmed, and the response has been pretty good by other commissioners as well.
Oh, good.
In addition, Jack Mead and Dave Murphy, Mary McIsaac will be joining because they finance directors and registers of deeds.
And do we have an agenda?
Not yet. We'll work on that.
Working on it,
yep.
Okay.
Yeah, so, a lot of it has to do with the legislative.
A lot of, yeah, right.
Yeah.
Legislation that we want to approach as regional governments. And
instead of having every county send in their own. And I want to thank Ron Beatty for pushing this a lot. He came to see me over a year ago and said, we should be doing this more often.
Yeah, I think every few months we were like, hey, what's going on with that association?
Yeah.
So the association is now back intact and actually meeting. So it's, thank
okay.
you.
Thank you.
On the East Wing, roof's done, HVAC's done, except for the electrical parts. The equipment will start coming in. The sheetrocking is almost done, and the paint is coming in the last week in December. Donnie estimates that certainly by mid to late February, we should have it open. So
the new East Wing Conference Room?
New
East Wing Conference. Assembly Chambers?
Right. Yeah. So it's now weather tight, thank goodness.
It's on the other side of right. the building.
Yep.
On the left.
I haven't been that side in a long time.
Yeah, it's really coming out quite nice.
Yeah.
Many thanks to Kevin for his great work up there.
So is that where we will meet eventually?
Probably. It'll be up to you. We can
yeah.
stay here.
Us.
But. The audiovisual equipment up there and all the electronics that are going to be up there bring us into the 21st century, so it probably makes sense to have our meetings
yeah,
up there.
Yeah, probably.
No. And we'll try to coordinate a little bit better with the assembly going forward. Well, on the dredge, both dredges have been running and working. The new dredge is in Barnstable. The Codfish just finished up in Harwich and is now down in Falmouth, and I just want to take a second to thank Greg Frazier from Falmouth, your harbor master, who mm-hmm. has been absolutely outstanding working with us on that. 4,000 brand new feet of pipe is being delivered as we speak. The last delivery is coming. Three deliveries have already been made, and Greg's helped us offload it and taking it down to the beach. He's helping us on Friday when the fusion machine comes in to, again, offload and get everything set up for next week so we can start fusing that pipe and get in the water. We have three jobs pending in Falmouth. None of them are big jobs, and we should be out of there in 2 weeks with the hope of getting into the Cape Cod Bay. The new dredge has engineers on it today from Ellicott, and their hope is to finish the Barnstable project in another 2 weeks or so, which was a major project. That dredge pumps 3 to 4 times what the Codfish can pump when it's running. The problem is it's so technically challenging for the crew that there have been a lot of snafus, and it gets shut down periodically. So Ellicott's up now and trying to keep it running through the bulk of the job, mm-hmm. and I appreciate their great efforts to do that. We should have a conversation in January. The Codfish is 20 years old. And it's been, it really has been a workhouse for us. And we started to look at the purchase of another dredge. And we'd obviously retrofit the Codfish as a backup, but it might be time to start to look at getting another dredge similar to the Codfish. Less technically challenging to the crew, but with a bigger pump. So we'll probably want to come back before the commissions and have this discussion in open session with the experts sometime in January. It will take 6 months to get it here,
yeah.
and we'd want it for next dredge season in September. So,
what is the dredge season? Is it spring or fall?
It's mostly winter.
Oh, winter?
Yeah, but it can run into the spring and fall, depending on where you are and what the season challenges are. The projects pending for the new dredge after Barnstable are Toon Bass River, Parkers River, Mashpee. So it's going to be busy right up to the end of the season, which is around February 9th. That's the absolute date. In Bass River, it's January 15th. So they really have to make a lot of progress and get a lot of work done between now and then to stay on schedule. And those are important jobs. They're all funded by Mass Works grants. So, and of course, Troll hasn't been done in years and has to get done. So these are all the things that are pending for two dredges. And it just makes sense to have have our dredge crew with efficient equipment that we can count on, so.
Jack, I'll just be honest with you, I'd be hesitant to begin that discussion until at least we're done with the budget review.
Right, yeah.
Because that's very, it'd be overwhelming.
Yeah.
You know, maybe immediately after. I mean, we're done with that with the first week of February or something.
Yeah, that's right, yeah. So right around then, yeah. I wouldn't challenge that. That would be too much. Budget's going to be full-time for us, yeah. Barnstable Fire Training Academy, in the last 2 weeks, a huge amount of work is going on up there. Birmingham has been brought in. They're capping right now. They're regrading. They're trenching. All consistent with what the Barnstable Conservation Commission has asked us to do. And every day, I think Phil sends pictures over to the Conservation Commission over in Barnstable. So a lot of the work that DEP asked us to do by the end of February is probably going to be done by mid-January. They've made huge strides out there. So I just wanted to give you a quick update there, and no surprises. Seeds, they talked a little bit about that today. One of the things about the seeds program they humbly didn't mention, Cape Cod Commission has done a great job of using the license plate money historically to leverage other money, like the EDA grant and the downtown facade grants that they've done in a number of towns like Barnstable and Falmouth. So kudos to them. It can be a good program when you mix and match, just as Ron said. When you do that, it can be a tremendous program because it gets you bang for the buck. And finally, I don't believe we're going to meet next week.
Unless there's an emergency or something that requires
so attention. I just want to take
29th?
A second.
No.
That's December 26th.
Yes,
it's the day after Christmas.
Oh, we haven't had Christmas yet.
Yeah, so I just want to take a second to wish you all a Merry Christmas. And thank you for
your
great support this year.
Merry Christmas to everybody and Happy New Year.
Yeah.
Okay.
Great, thanks.
Thank you. I'd like to have a motion to adjourn.
So move.
Second. BDI.
Flynn I.
We're adjourned.
We are adjourned. So Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Happy holidays.